No, it's, we are far from it, because now we have the new investment fund. I was happy that it's going to take part of the budget of the connecting door facility, because what I was supporting was the idea of the financial instruments, because there are never enough public money to support the investments, and I think there are important international investors that would want to get in with public money. But the use of these funds for greater leverage in order to attract investment or make the investment cheaper, it makes sense for me. But since now I hear that, for example, in terms of LNG infrastructure, we have enough, nearly enough, because we don't use the whole capacity. My question would be, what is the new calculation of the needed investment? So with the interconnectors, with what else is needed in the infrastructure in order to make sure that we have interconnected infrastructure to have a market. What is the new calculation for the need of investment in infrastructure? That's the commission now. Did the industry made a new calculation? Because while we were talking in connecting new facility was 500 billion. But I think at that time we thought we have to invest more in LNG.
I don't remember the number. I mean, there are some calculation from IA and others on how much of this, but it's also what is the only portion of kind of to connect Europe. But then there's what we need to replace old facilities, etc. So there's a whole, you know, I think there are various layers of, you know, there's a lot of old infrastructure that has to be replaced. You need some new infrastructure. You need to connect markets that are not connected. So, you know, there's a lot of layers. So the final number of all of that and this bit I don't have. But it's more than what the Juncker Fund will be better, I can tell you.
And as you say, Mrs. Aldean, there is overall enough capacity for LNG. The problem is that the capacity is not necessarily accessible for all member states, but where it is currently. And that is the challenge, notably for Southeastern Europe. They do not have yet a kind of sufficient connection to the liquid gas hubs, which are closest to them. And the LNG capacity is mostly there in Western Europe, and also now increasingly in the Baltic Sea, with the Lithuanian terminal and the Polish terminal in Świnoujście being built. So the main challenge is still Southeastern Europe, and there's quite a concrete project already going on in Croatia for Krk, and possibly also for Greece, for the Golden Shore, which could actually ensure that. So that would be the two projects which would, in our feeling, still be useful and probably even necessary to ensure that every single member state has access sufficiently to LNG. So that would be further investment projects, and I don't recall now exactly the figures, but these are considered in the PCI and CESEC processes, so there has already quite a lot of work being done on that, which would require new investments, and then of course interconnections through pipelines to the liquid gas hubs, basically, which are being done throughout Southeastern Europe, including reverse flows from Greece to Bulgaria, and making sure that the gas can flow also from the Mediterranean up there.
But also just to kind of throw out some numbers.